Hello everyone, so we are going to discuss about the sources of drugs, rather the plants and animals as the sources of drug in this video. So first of all, let us have a look that how do plants act as the source of drug. So for this, we are going to study about the classification of plants as sources of drugs. So the drugs or the crude drugs that are obtained from the plants can be of two types, the organized drugs or the unorganized drugs. Organized drugs means as such the plant part which is being used for medicinal purposes. So these organized drugs contain some of the cellular tissue arrangement, while the unorganized drugs are the exudations that are obtained from the plants, or these are the plant products we can say. So they do not contain any of the cellular arrangement or the tissues. So the organized drugs can be classified under two heads, the overground organs or the underground organs. In overground organs or the organs that are present above the ground, we have herbs, leaves, flowers, fruits, seeds, barks and woods. The underground organs of plant include roots, rhizomes, bulbs and corms. Now the unorganized drugs, the examples are juices, lattices, extracts, alkaloids, glycosides, tannins, resins and balsams, volatile oils, fixed oils and fats, waxes, gums and mucilage. So now let us have a look at the individual. So for example, the organized plant drugs first. So woods, example sandalwood. Then leaves, example there are many, few of those are given here. For example, you have eucalyptus, tulsi and tea. Then barks, the example is Arjuna, Ashoka, cinnamon. Flowering parts, the examples are clove and saffron. The fruits, example are amla, coriander and fennel. Seeds, examples are black mustard, cardamom and spagula. Roots and rhizomes, examples are ginger, glycyrrhiza and turmeric. Then complete plants or the complete herbs are also used. For example, in case of vinca, neem and brahmi. Hair and fibers, for example, you have cotton, jute and silk. Now let us have a look at the unorganized plant drugs examples. Dried latex, as in case of opium, pepain from papaya. Then dried juice is used in some cases, for example, in aloe and kinu. Dried extracts, for example, in agar and black cartechu. Waxes, for example, beeswax and carnauba wax. Gums, for example, acacia and tragacanth. Raisins, for example, you have asafoetida and benzoin. Volatile oil, the examples are sandalwood, clove and eucalyptus. Fats and fixed oils, examples are castor, coconut, olive, cocum butter. Animal products, the examples are beeswax, gelatin and honey. Then fossil organism and minerals, the examples are bentonite, kaolin and talc. Now let us have a look at how the animals act as the sources of drugs. So there are various products that are obtained from animals which act as the sources of drug. For example, you have hormones, enzymes and some miscellaneous compounds. So hormones, for example, thyroid, then you have estrogens, insulin, oxytocin and gonadotropins. So wherever the patient is suffering from a deficiency, any deficiency disease in which these enzymes are in the much lower concentration as that is required, so these can be given. Then enzymes, pancreatin, trypsin, fibrinolysin, pepsin and hyaluronidase. Then there are some miscellaneous products that are obtained from the animal sources. For example, we have the dye which is obtained from cantharides. So the entire animal is used here, entire insect is used, and it is then dried, and then from that the dye is prepared. So the entire animals, for example cantharides, it is used as a dye. Then some fixed oils are also obtained from animals like cod liver oil, which is used as a source of vitamin A and vitamin D. So that's all with the plant and animal as sources of drugs. Thank you.